Yo guys, what is going on? Mortex here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to put games onto your RG350. Two different ways, pretty similar in method, but you may not have both of these lying around. So the first way is going to be via a USB-C type cable, and the second way is going to be by an SD card reader. So let's get into the first way. So what we're going to do is we are going to actually plug the USB type C into USB port number 2. That's right, it's going to be port number 2. Don't use port number 1 because it won't work. So let's get this on the road. So when we get into the device, we're going to go over to settings. So you've got application, emulators, games, and then we've got settings. Now we need to move over to the network tab, and once we've launched this, we will get the FTP configuration network settings. Now firstly, what you need to do is you want to go to disable login, so you don't want any passwords on this. You can always put allow login without password, which I just keep it on anyway, but we need to keep it on this, and we need to look at the IP address because we're going to need that later on. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to hop over to the PC, and we are going to show you how to do this. So guys, you're on the PC now, and the first thing you want to do is click on the PC and then go to the top and click add a network location. Now once you've done this, click the wizard, go through next and next onto it. You don't really need to worry about this. Now this is the most important part of the video. We need to get the FTP site address put in here. I'm going to leave a description below so you can copy and paste it, but this will allow the RG350 and the PC to connect together. Now you've got a username and password requirement. I never really fill this in because it's my own PC. You can fill this in if you want to put a password onto it, but I wouldn't really recommend it. You don't really need to do this, so you can just press next and skip this. Now you can also call the network something. I like to just call it the RG350, so I know where the network is on my system and it's easier to find. Once we've done this, we are actually in the internal card. So we've got the apps, home, and media. So you may have different things in the internal card depending on how it's set up. Mine's set up with some custom firmware, so I've set it up a bit different, but I'll still show you where the emulator files are kept. So we click into media, then we go onto data, and then we go onto the ROM folder. Now this is where all the emulator folders will be kept. So I just want to click into PS1, and then I can go into my ROMs and basically just drag and drop. Let it copy over, and then there you go. You've installed ROMs onto your internal SD card. Now these are an easier way, and this is just to do it with the external SD card and an SD card reader, which I will show you how to do now. Back onto the PC again, and now all we need to do is go into this USB drive. So this is the SD card, I don't really name it anything, and all I've basically done is got all my emulators that I actually use. So I don't use that many, pretty selective when it comes to my emulators. I do love PS1 though. So all you basically need to do, the folders will all be set up. All you have to do is click on the folder, and then if you wanted to drag and drop a ROM in, all you would do is go like so, open the file, drag and drop, and that's it. So we'll go back over to the device now just to show you where the games are kept. And now to access them, because I know some people may be a bit confused on this, but it is pretty simple. So we'll put the SD card back in the RG350. Now I want to tell you how to find the location where you put your actual games and folders. So we're doing it from the external, which is a lot easier than the internal, but all you have to do is press select, and you put add a link in emulators, you press A, and then now this is where you're going to find it. So if you're doing it from the internal side of things, you will go data, then you will go ROMs, and then pick which one you've got. So the PS1 is there, but my ROMs are kept on the external one. So what we're going to do is go SD, PS1, and then all we do is press start to confirm where the folders are kept. And then basically we can go back in, we can press A, and there we go. There we have all the games that are put onto the device. So pretty simple, pretty quick way of doing it, guys. Hopefully this has helped you out a lot, because I know when I first got this device, I was struggling quite a lot to understand how to even put the games onto the system. Don't forget, guys, please like, rate, and subscribe. And if you're struggling with this at all, please give me a comment below and I will try my best to help you out and walk through it, and we'll get through this together. So until next time, guys, I'll see you soon.